Hello, good evening, and welcome to the BBC Radio 2 Young Choristers of the Year for 2018. My name is Radzi Chinyanganya, and it's an honour to be hosting this year's competition from the studios at Media City in Salford. These studios are the home of the BBC Philharmonic Orchestra, which records and performs more than 100 concerts every single year for BBC Radio and welcomes more than 5,000 people to its studios. The two winners tonight, one girl and one boy, can look forward to returning here to record music with the BBC's Philharmonic Orchestra for use with a number of different programmes. The competition aims to find and reward young singers who've contributed to the music at their chapel, school, church or cathedral. The BBC has been celebrating the talents of young choristers for more than 30 years now. Eight young people, the finalists, have come through two rounds of judging to win their place in tonight's final. Listening closely to their singing will be our judges tonight, and it's time to officially introduce the judges. Responsible for choosing one boy and one girl sitting in front of me, we have a composer, conductor, and one-time cathedral organist and director of music at Sheffield and Salisbury Cathedrals, Simon Lowell. He's an old hand at the competition, having been a musical director on a number of occasions. But here, for the first time, the founder and director of one of the largest contemporary choirs in the world, the illustrious Rock Choir, who were featured on BBC Radio 2 as part of this year's Proms in the Park, Caroline Redmond-Lusher. Keeping them in order, however, is someone else also familiar with the competition. He's been described as a contemporary hero of British choral music. Since 1997, he's been a full-time composer. Our chair of judges, Bob Chilcott. Bob, and to kick things off, what's important to you about our winner? How are you going to select them?
Well, all the singers here, they've really shown that they've got a significant amount of skill being here already. So really, I think probably we'll be looking for the performance element and the communication and what the song means.
Ladies and gentlemen, our judges. It's time, though, to get on with the competition. Each of the finalists will be singing two pieces of music and will be accompanied by our musical director tonight, Darius Batiwala. Time, though, to hear from the boys themselves. Early this afternoon, we asked them to introduce themselves, and here's what they said.
I'm Cassian. I sing in Tewkesbury Abbey. I'm in my final year now after 4.5 years singing there, and I do regular even songs every week. My parents tell me that at the age of 1 or 2, I was hearing songs on the radio and then just repeating them, just singing them. When I'm singing at home, I think that nobody's listening, but they are. So it's a nice formal setting and performing to other people as well.
I'm Ollie Simcock. I'm 12 years old. I was head chorister at St Mary's. I had been singing there for 3 years, and I now sing for Warwick School. I sung some arias in Handel's Messiah earlier this year, and I've sung some in Mozart's Requiem as well. I'd practice at home if I have time with stuff like homework and other practices going on.
I'm Alexander Leatherbarrow, the deputy head chorister at Liverpool Cathedral, and my hobbies consist of rugby and badminton. I went for this audition, went in feeling super nervous. When I found out I got in, I was like really, really happy, you know, sense of euphoria. First you start with a bit of nerves, but then when you see the look on people's faces and when you're singing solos and arias and all that, you just feel amazed by how you're making these other people happy, and that makes me happy.
I'm Frederick Butler. I've been singing at Canterbury Cathedral Choir for 3 and a bit years. I like to be there because lots of people come, and I like seeing smiley faces from the audience. Sometimes when I've got solo, I'm a little bit nervous, though nowadays after being there for 3 years, it's just every day.
I have to say, I spoke to them earlier on, and their composure is just astounding. Although, to pick up on one point that was made, my voice is very much broken, but even beforehand, I wouldn't have had a chance of sitting where you are. So, boys, all the very best of luck. Our first finalist now, though, is Cassian Pichler-Roca. Cassian is a pupil at Dean Close School in Cheltenham and a member of Tewkesbury Abbey Scholar Cantorum. Tonight, Cassian is singing John Dankworth's Light of the World, followed by the hymn Christ Triumphant to the tune Guiting Power. Cassian, you were the first off this evening. How are you feeling?
Just buzzing after performing to all of these people, seeing the smiles on the faces as well, so it's great.
And you left us off first. I think you did absolutely fantastically. Were you happy with your performance?
Yeah, absolutely amazing. It's just great having performed first. It's great. And now I can listen to everybody else smash it as well. So
you should be very proud. And I imagine you're talented in one area. It's not like you'd speak more than one language, for example. I mean, how many European languages do you speak?
Three. And learning French as well at school, so that's pretty cool, I guess.
Which ones do you speak?
I speak English, Spanish and German. So my mum's Spanish and my dad's Italian, but he comes from a region which speak German.
Cassian, you were fantastic. Simon, what did you make of it?
Well, I think starting off and being the first is really difficult, and I think you've set the benchmark here. I thought you sang absolutely beautifully. Two pieces that I really enjoy, the Johnny Dankworth piece is a wonderful piece. I thought you sang with great understanding and you got into the piece. I like the fact that you communicated with the audience, you were looking at us, you did it without the music as well, I don't know how you did that. And Guiting Power as well was beautifully sung, very clear. And your rapport with your accompanist as well was excellent. So thank you. You've really set the standard very high to start off with.
Thank you. Well, once more, can we give a massive round of applause for Cassian?
Now we are well underway, and singing next is Oliver Simcock, who's a music and choral scholar at Warwick School and sings with Warwickshire County Choristers. Tonight he's singing Dear Lord and Father of Mankind, and Edmund Rubra's hymn to the Virgin. Oliver, well done. How was that for you?
Nerve-wracking.
Another love of yours, I understand, which I know really helps the vocal cords, the Xbox.
Yeah.
Now, what does your dad think about you playing the Xbox?
Doesn't like it when I play it too much.
Is Dad in the audience now?
Yes.
Do we think Oliver will get to play a little bit more Xbox after that performance, Dad. Caroline, a very, very challenging repertoire for such a young singer.
Oh, but Oliver, you're just lovely to watch. You really are. And I think it took you a little bit of time to settle. The second piece, you were much more confident. And we started to see much more of you in that second piece. And of course, it allowed you to expose your voice a lot more. And the clarity was beautiful. And you should be really, really proud of yourself. It's a scary thing to come to something like this. So congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you, Caroline, once more for Oliver.
Our third competitor tonight is Alexander Leatherbarrow. He's a chorister at Liverpool Anglican Cathedral. Tonight, he's singing Michael Head's The Little Road to Bethlehem and My Heart Ever Faithful by J.S. Bach.
As I walked down the road at set of sun, the lambs were coming homewards one by one. I heard a shepherd softly calling them along the little road to Bethlehem. Beside an open door, as I drew nigh, I heard sweet Mary sing a lullaby. She sang about the lambs at close of day, and rocked her tiny king among the hay. Across the earth a silver sheep bell rang, the lambs are coming home, sweet Mary sang. You star of God, you star of God is shining in the sky. So sleep, my little king, go lullaby.
Alexander, did you enjoy that?
I did. There were some slight errors, but they could have been adjusted.
So I think you're being your own harshest critic there. That might be because you come from a family of choristers.
Yeah. My great uncle was a chorister at Liverpool Cathedral. We've had a line of head choristers. My mum's been a singer, but she never made it into the cathedral because it was before the girls' choir was started.
Well, mum seems to give you the smile of approval there. What is the best thing about being a chorister?
Oh, it's obviously the everyday life and the family aspect of things. The singing's great, being able to show off your talent is great, but also having supporting members around you that can cover for you, and just, it's a big family.
Bob, what did you make of the performance?
Well, Alexander, congratulations. Anyone who sings will know how difficult it is to sing that Bach. And you did brilliantly, I have to say. Clarity, well done, beautiful.
Thank you.
Next to the stage is Frederick Butler. Frederick has been a chorister at Canterbury Cathedral for more than 3 years. He'll be singing the hymn City of God, How Broad and Far, to the tune Richmond, followed by Howard Goodall's arrangement of Love Divine.
Frederick, you look like you really enjoyed that. How was it?
Nerve-wracking, but I still enjoyed it in the end.
Well, you couldn't tell you were nervous at all. Can I ask you about one of your favourite memories from being able to actually sing at Canterbury Cathedral?
Well, probably my most memorable moment was my second Christmas. Being here is my first Christmas. I accidentally burnt someone with a candle. Though the second Christmas was much better, and I just really enjoyed the border choir activities and just being there.
Can I ask you about how you burnt someone with a candle? I'm really curious to know.
Well, I was sort of walking down the stairs and then they stopped and I went into them.
It's basically their fault, let's be honest. Simon, what did you make? We had a contemporary piece and a traditional one as well.
Well, I really enjoyed it. I'll let you into a secret that I was a chorister at St Paul's many years ago, and City of God was my voice trial piece, and I started to feel nervous while you were singing it, but you were so confident. And what I liked about... I'm always aware with hymns, cathedral choristers are singing hymns all the time, but you really brought a sense of understanding and a sense of the phrasing. Your breathing was really good, so I enjoyed that very much. So thank you for that and bringing back a few nostalgic memories. The Howard Goodall, I really felt... came alive. You clearly enjoyed that so much. It was a lovely choice of piece. You portrayed in your body language as well in your musicality the real sense of praise in that lovely piece. So fantastic. Congratulations.
Thank you. And one more time for Frederick.
Well, it's safe to say I do not envy the judges' jobs at all. We are now halfway through the competition, but there is still plenty more to come. You're listening to the final of BBC Radio 2 Young Choristers of the Year 2018 with me, Radzi Chinyanganya. Now, though, it's the girls' turn to sing. But first, let's hear from them about why they enjoy singing.
I'm Grace, I'm 15, and I'm from St. Asaph Cathedral. It's quite a small choir in a small city in Wales. And I really like how small it is because we all know each other really, really well. And I also sing in a school chamber choir where we sometimes sing in Chester Cathedral. And I also sing in the National Youth Choir.
I'm Amelia, I'm 15, and I sing with my school choir from Queen Mary's Thusk. I've just been made music captain and head chorister. It involves firstly, helping out the director of music with timetabling and taking rehearsals and occasionally organising the odd event.
I'm Sophie and I'm 15 years old and I sing with St Matthew's Church, Northampton.
But when you're singing sort of choral music and it's got masses of parts and everyone has their part to play and it all links together and it only sounds amazing when everyone does it and everyone sort of puts in their all. I listen to quite a variety of music. I've just become a fan of Iron Maiden.
I'm Brooke, I'm 15, and I sing with Norwich Cathedral Choir. And the thing I like most about it is making the friends and finding people who have the same passions as you so you can explore what other people have. I do boxing with my dad, and then I do choir with school, which is chapel choir, and then I do some orchestras as well, like jazz band and stuff.
Our first finalist in the girls' category is Grace Dixon. Grace is a chorister at St Asaph Cathedral in North Wales and also sings with the National Youth Choir of Great Britain. She's singing two pieces, Make Me a Channel of Your Peace and Handel's How Beautiful Are the Feet.
Where there's doubt, true faith in you.
First of all, well done. You were the very first girl to sing for us this evening. How was it?
Oh, it was amazing. I love performing in front of people. It gives me a real rush.
Well, I think your performance was amazing. Just finally, do you have any favourite subjects at school?
I really like history and classics.
And do you know what you like to do when you're older?
Maybe a lawyer.
No more questions, Joanna. Bob, how did you do?
I thought that was lovely. In the Handel, to start phrases on high notes is really hard. You did that beautifully. And you gave us the atmosphere of the text, which I really like. You changed it from the hymn. Hymns are very, very hard to sing and to make a good line. And you know, that's a well-known piece. I thought you did it beautifully. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Bob, and thank you, Grace.
Second to sing for the girls is Amelia Jakes. She's head chorister at Queen Mary's School in Thirsk and sings with the National Youth Choir. Amelia is going to sing, "Stainers Come, Thou Long Expected Jesus, and Blessed Are All They That Fear the Lord," by Handel.
Israel's strength and courage.
Amelia, I could tell by the size of the smile on your face when you finished. You seemed like you really enjoyed that. How was it?
It was good fun. I really enjoyed it. I just enjoyed singing to you all, so thank you.
Well, we enjoyed hearing it. You also competed in last year's finals. Yeah. How did the two compare?
Well, obviously, different repertoire, different competitors, but I knew the space and I knew kind of the format of the day, so I kind of knew what was happening there. But this year I went for a more quick piece, whereas last year I did a slow piece, so it's just approaching different repertoire, which was really good.
Simon, what did you make of it?
Well, I thought it was a wonderful choice of music, as you say. The Stainer, I thought you sang with great feeling, really good sense of line. Again, your breath control was great, nice full tone that you had. And then I thought it was great that you chose that particular piece of Handel. We often hear one or two very well-known bits of Handel, but this isn't quite so well-known, and so there was a great choice and exciting. And you really brought it to life, all those semiquavers. Your technique was excellent, the sense of energy as you sang, sense of line and flow was really good. I really enjoyed it, so congratulations.
Thank you, Simon, and once more for Amelia.
Our penultimate singer tonight is Sophie Stringfellow, who sings as a chorister in the choir of St. Matthew's Church in Northampton. Tonight she's singing Be Thou My Vision to the tune Slain, followed by a setting of the hymn It's a Thing Most Wonderful by John Ireland.
Oh,
Sophie, it's all over now. How are you feeling?
Oh, it's amazing. It's a wonderful piece.
Now, when I went to go and wish you guys good luck earlier on, there was one person revising for their maths exam. That was you, Sophie. Were you even slightly nervous?
I was a bit, but I was trying to keep my mind off it.
Well, it definitely worked. Also, when we heard the introducing piece, we heard that you're into Iron Maiden. So how do you go from chorister to Iron Maiden?
I love all types of music, as long as it's sort of well put together. And I love the way it's created in layers. And my favourite song starts with this really lyrical guitar that doesn't sound anything like sort of heavy metal. And then it all suddenly builds up in layers, and it's really cool.
Well, Caroline, you have an experience in crossover. Do you think in the future, Sophie could be singing on stage at some time with Iron Maiden?
Iron Maiden. I love that you're into Iron Maiden. I've actually been listening to it in the car on the way up today, so we're both into that. Just a beautiful voice, and you really owned your performance, and we could see the emotion coming through you. The phrasing and those very top notes were just beautiful. You should be really, really proud of what you've done today. Well done.
Caroline, thank you, and well done, Sophie.
Well, after a very long wait, our last finalist is Brooke Ellie. She sings at Norwich Cathedral. Brooke is singing Stuart Townend, The Lord is My Shepherd, and P.A. Jesu by Andrew Lloyd Webber.
The Lord's my shepherd, I'll not want. He makes me lie in pastures green. He leads me by the still, still waters. His goodness restores my soul.
Brooke, you were the last person to perform, but you did it. How are you feeling?
Obviously nervous, but it's so nice to hear everyone else and then finally get to perform.
Being sat there, did the nerves build at all?
Yes, it does. It very much does.
Now, I'm partly surprised at that because you yourself admitted you like boxing.
Yeah, a few years ago, me and my dad were looking on the internet to see what sport we should do. And I thought, well, I wanted to do boxing when I was younger, so why not try it now? And I've had a lesson, and I absolutely fell in love with it.
Well, Bob, what did you make of it?
Do you think if I say something bad, she'll hit me? No, Brooke, well done. Having to wait till the end is a tough deal. And you did so well. And what was so impressive was the first song was quite low-lying, and you had to find that sound for that. And then, of course, suddenly in that Lloyd Webber, the top note comes out of nowhere, and you managed that really well. It's a brave choice, beautiful. So well done, really. Thank you. You won't hit me, will you?
Bob, just the final word on all of the finalists this evening. What have you made of the calibre?
Well, incredibly high standard. I think I can feel from my colleagues here how moved we are to hear such fine singing. It takes a lot of courage to stand up on your own and sing, and I think you did that admirably. And I've been incredibly moved by it. Thank you.
Thank you, Bob.
The judges now have to leave us as they have the unenviable task of choosing just two winners. So with that in mind, Simon Lowell, Caroline Redmond-Lusher and Bob Chilcott will give you a round of applause as you make your way out to go and choose the BBC Radio 2 Young Choristers of the Year for 2018. While the judges are talking, it's time to change musical gear a little. Our guest tonight is about to embark on a nationwide tour. Don't Dim Your Light for Anyone will feature on her new album, and I'm very excited to say it receives its first public performance here tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Thea Gilmore.
This tough, but I know you Some trust in God, some just pass through. But me, my love, I trust in you. When all that stuff blocks out the sun, don't dim your light for anyone. Don't dim your light for anyone.
Thea Gilmore, thank you very much for coming here and performing like that. Good luck with your new album and your upcoming tour. Once more, can we please hear it for Thea Gilmore? Well, I've just been informed that the judges have made their decisions and the results are officially in. So can we please welcome back to this gorgeous studio, the judges. Well, Bob, it's my honour to say, please do the honours.
It's my pleasure to announce the BBC Radio 2 Young Choristers of the Year 2018. Cassian, Pichler-Roca, and Amelia Jakes.
Cassian Pichler-Roca and Amelia Jakes will now sing Brother James Eyre. So all that remains for me to do is say a massive thank you to our wonderful judges, Simon Lowell, Caroline Redmond-Lusher, and Bob Chilcott. Also thank you to Darius Batiwala, who's accompanied all of our singers tonight, our special guest, Thea Gilmore, our technical team, and myself, Radzi Chinyanganya, our organiser tonight, Chloe Bell, and producer, Janet McClarty. A very good night to you all.
This is BBC Radio 2. Online, on digital radio.